if I could work hard every day, with the being blessed with the physical tools that I have, what would my career be? And I made a promise to myself from that day that I was going to work hard every single day so that when I do retire, I have no regrets. And that was the most important thing for me, is to leave no stone unturned, get better every single day. And if I live that way, then over time, you know, I'd have something that was beautiful. But that was my philosophy. It seems like a pretty simple one, but you know, if you live your life to just get better every single day, and do that for 20 years, I mean, what do you have? That's the trick, isn't it? It's finding what you love to do. I mean, we talk about hard work all the time. It's like, you know, man, if you got to get up every single morning and remind yourself how hard you need to work, you probably need to choose a different profession, you know? Because that shouldn't be there. I wake up in the morning excited to get to it. You know, if I'm not training, I'm missing it. If I'm not watching a game of basketball, I miss it. There's no place I'd rather be. And if you have that feeling, then you're truly doing what God has put you on this earth to do. I think the best way to prove your value is to work, is to learn, is to absorb, to be a sponge. Okay? But you always want to outwork your potential. You know, as hard as you believe you can work harder than that. And that's what I tried to do when I first came in the league. But you know, basketball is such a direct competition sport that me coming in at 17, I hated when like my teammates would say, I get hit with an elbow, right? Shaq would hit me with an elbow in practice. And like I always had that extra chip on my shoulder. So like every day in practice for me was really trying to annihilate everybody that I was playing against. Because I wanted to prove you don't need to babysit me. Like I'm fine, you know? And so it's always that competitive nature, the work ethic, and curiosity. Because I asked a lot of questions. You know, playing with Byron Scott, I asked him a lot of questions. Eddie Jones, who was great at chasing guards off the screens, and I didn't understand how to do that. I would sit with him before practice, after practice. Magic, James Worthy, Kurt Rambis, Kareem Abdul, all the Laker greats, I would always sit down and just ask them questions about certain games that I studied growing up. What actually happened there? What did you feel there? Why? Phil introduced meditation to us when he came to our team in 99-2000. It was something that I instantly gravitated to because I could see the effects. Right? I used to watch, studying the games, the Bulls teams, and watching their demeanor, watching their composure, playing in a tough place like Utah, doing the finals and being down 17. You couldn't tell if they were down 17 or up 20 or a tie game, and never changed. And I was wondering why the hell that is. And that's when I started doing more research. And when Phil came, I immediately gravitated to him and found myself accepting the challenge of finding what that space is. And for the 81-point game, man, to be honest, I wasn't even thinking about the game. My knee was hurting so much. I didn't know then, but I had a flap of joint, of cartilage stuck in my joint line. And so my mind was really trying to go to a place where I don't feel that pain. The game started, and because of that, I was just in a different space. I wasn't worried about what was to come. I wasn't worried about what just happened. I was just here. And when you're just there in the moment, playing plays right in front of you, your focus is heightened because nothing else matters. That's the space I've tried to get to.
46 from the field. This would be 18 for 20 from the line, and an 81-point game. 55 and